Hey, this is Heather from Tye-Dyed Iguana, and today we're going to go over the differences between male and female chameleons. Now, in this video, we're going to show you using our both our veiled chameleons and our panther chameleons, and we also have a baby Jackson's chameleon that we're also going to use to kind of show you what the differences are. So we get asked this a lot, like, how can I tell if my baby is a male or female? So we're just going to try to answer that question in today's video. All right, so today we're going to get a little help from our baby veiled chameleons over here. Now, veiled chameleons, they're one of the easiest species to identify between male and female. Almost when they're hatchlings, you can determine whether you've got a male or female, and there is one really easy way. Once they get to be adults, then there's like bigger differences, but there's one surefire way to tell the difference between a male and a female baby. Alright, so first off, we're going to start looking at this little guy. This is actually a boy. Now, the reason why I know this is because of those back feet. Spin around, little guy. Now, he's on the move, so this might be a little tough to see. What you want to do is you want to look at the back of their hind feet. Okay, let's see. You see that spur? I'll take a quick snapshot of it so that you can see. Now they have a little nub on the back of their feet. he's trying to get on the camera. He's really sticking. See? There. See that little fleshy knob sticking out? You can see it really good there. Those are what the boys have. Now the girls, they don't have that. You can see them kind of sticking out of the back of his heels. So yeah, the boys, they have that. And you can see them really early on in their development when they're just a few weeks old or so. But yeah, that's the big difference between the babies. I'll show you a female right here. All right, so here's one of our little girls. We have two girls in the tank. And then we'll kind of show you that back of that foot. It just has the heel there. So yeah, it's completely flat. You'll notice there's nothing sticking out of the back there. So that is a surefire way to tell if this is a female. Doesn't have that tarsal spur at all. I don't know if I mentioned that's what it's called. It's called the tarsal spur. Just an extra spur on the back of their foot. Sometimes you'll get kind of chunky female veiled chameleons, and the back of their heels look kind of chunky, and some people mistake that for a tarsal spur, but nope. It's tarsal spur, especially as they get older, it gets to be more like, almost it looks like an extra toe. Say yeah. There's that foot, that flat foot. Say no spur on that one. So definitely a female. And when they get older, the males, they'll get like more prominent casques, which is what they're named for, the veil. The casque is that, not the crest on the top of their head. The males will get much taller, bigger crests than females. And the males, they also have more the red, bright yellow coloration. The females, they can get pretty yellow and green and brown with brown spots too. But the males definitely get more colorful than they do. A lot brighter yellow and even orange. So yeah. All right, so the second species we're gonna take a look at today is the panther chameleon. And this is our girl. Now she's pretty young yet still, but we've noticed that with a lot of the specific locale of panther chameleons we get, the females have this really nice peach color, but that is not typical of all your different locales of panther chameleons. Females can come in all sorts of different colors, but they have more bland colors usually than the males do. So by this time you can pretty much tell she's not going to get the nice greens and blues of the male that the males usually get, like the greens, blues, and yellows. So she's definitely a girl. And the other way to tell, especially when they get older, is if you look at the base of the tail. See if we can see her. Yeah, they don't have the spurs like the veiled chameleons do, so it's a little harder when they're babies, especially. You gotta wait till they get a little older. See how her base of her tail is nice and flat behind her vent? That's a good sign that she's female. And when they're older, that'll develop much more. Like when the males get older, they get this really big bulge, like right there behind the vent. They get the base of their tail is really bulged there. And yeah, that happens when they're much older though. But we actually have a male that I'm going to take a look at, and we're going to show you the difference in just the color, and they're the same age. So we'll go see him real quick. All right, so this is our male Panther Chameleon. And he's kind of got his hot orange and black colors going right now. But I will see. I think the base of his tail, he's just starting to get that bulge. You can kind of see it. Oh, he's like, nope, I'm not going to show you. Yeah, there's like a slight fattening down at the bottom behind his vent. And that's one of the good ways to tell he's a male. Once he gets bigger, they'll become a lot more pronounced. We'll see if we can get him to show his colors. Okay, so you see that nice... he's like, no. He's got that nice green, yellow. It's kind of hard to tell in this light, but he's got that bright red and kind of yellow going on. He's probably going to develop that as he gets bigger, but he's just kind of mad right now. You can see just how red his chest is starting to get. But you can kind of see that hint of green that he's going to be developing. A lot more green, and then the reds. And then it looks like he's probably going to have like a yellow back with the striping, which is really cool. And you can kind of see that little fattening at the base of the tail. So that's where their hemipenes are. So that's just a normal thing. And you can see he doesn't have any spurs on the back of his feet. That is just a veiled chameleon thing. Other species of chameleons might have that too. I'm not quite sure, but this just kind of shows you just the big difference in coloration. He's got the greens, reds, and yellows kind of starting to develop. And that female is just a nice kind of a brownish peach color, pinkish peach. So yeah, just a cool way to tell them apart. And then last we'll talk about our little Jackson's Chameleon. You can see really good from this angle those three horns at the front, one in front of each eye and then one on the nose. That is what the males will get. The females of the Jackson's Chameleon, they do not get those three horns. Okay, so he wanted to come hang out in my hand for a little while. So yeah, the baby, when they're babies, when they're really tiny, even tinier than this, you'll notice the males have really prominent bumps in the front of their eyes and their nose. That shows that the horns are going to be developing. Females, not so much. They don't have those bumps. So definitely pretty easy to tell between a female and a male Jackson's.